Okay, SAS stands for Statistical Analysis System. The name itself says our software is an analysis tool. We do some statistical analysis using the software SAS. Okay, right. So SAS is pronounced as SAS, but now it is only SAS because there is one more technology with SAAS, SAS. So దాన్ని కూడా SAS అంటున్నారు and this is also called as SAS. So people gets confused. So we have one more technology called SAAS, SAS. So that is the reason now we are calling it as simply SAS. That's it. It's not SAS. Okay, right. SAS was initially found in North Carolina State University to analyze agricultural research data. Okay, and it was founded in 1976. So in 1970s or 1960s, so main occupation of people is farming. Okay, cultivation. So during that time, it was discovered to do some analysis on agricultural data. Okay, right. So mainly here we have two types. So here mainly we need to focus on two concepts. One is technology and the other one is domain. Okay, so if you ask any one of your friends, he says I'm working as a software engineer. Okay, software engineer means he is working on some software, suppose to say some Java or .NET. So most commonly known softwares are Java and .NET. So using .NET, what he is doing? Using Java, what he is doing? He is designing a banking page. So he is designing one domain site, so which is related to some banking, so which is related to some HDFC bank. Okay, so the technology here they are using is .NET and the domain they are working on is banking finance. Okay, so likewise our technology is SAS, SAS, and the domain we are working on will be clinical. Okay, so Sharagar, by the way, like what is your qualification? Superb, good, done. Everybody is from pharmacy background, so I can focus much into pharmacy clinical domain. Right, good. So now I'll just go to the basics of clinical domain, because technology you will find n number of presentations. If you go to Google, so this is your data set, this is your proc set, you will find n number of books and notes. No issues for technology. Fine. For domain, you don't have specific books. People who is working in a real-time scenario can only explain you the domain. Okay, so my presentation goes in such a way that first of all, I'll explain you what is a clinical domain, what are the activities being conducted in a clinical domain. And later on, I'll show you how your SAS is being used in clinical domain. Actually, area low, at which point of time we will use SAS in this domain. Okay, I'll explain you that. Fine. So now, first of all, clinical domain. Clinical domain is nothing but clinical R&D. So in R&D we do experiments, right? So clinical experiment. Okay, clinical experiment is also called a clinical trial. Okay, so whenever we are doing an experiment, we have basic objectives. So when we are doing an experiment, when you are in class 2, you have done some experiments in some your physics laboratory and chemistry laboratory, right? So if you are combining this with this chemical with this chemical, you will get some another. Okay, so whenever you are doing an experiment, you will have some objective. Okay, in clinical trial we have basically two objectives. First one is primary objective. The primary objective of conducting a clinical trial is to assess safety of humans. Okay, to assess safety of humans. Okay, so in olden days how people used to be, you know, scientists used to be, you know, if suppose if any person is getting some typhoid, so typhoid, how many people they get? Only one or two people. But to do a research to find a molecule, one person is enough? No. So what they are going to do is they are going to take these malarian parasites or suppose some typhoid related viruses, they used to inject in healthy persons. they used to make them sick, and after that they used to do their experiments. Okay, is that good to humans? No. Okay, so first of all, to assess the safety of humans, boss, please do, you are free to do anything in research, but at the same time, please don't hurt others in the name of research. Okay, so the primary objective is not to hurt anyone in the name of research. And secondary objective is to assess efficacy of drug. I mean to say, how drug is working, to understand, to assess efficacy of drug, how this drug is working inside your body. Okay, so these are the two objectives, primary, secondary objectives of conducting a clinical trial, right? So first of all, your formulations research, how a cycle will be, how a drug development process will be, is, see, first of all, they will take senses. Out of senses, suppose these are your senses. In 2015, there were some 5 lakh people died. Okay, 5 lakh people died. Out of these 5 lakh people, 2 lakh people died due to road accidents, suppose. Okay. And 1 lakh people died due to diseases. Suppose we say new diseases we are seeing, right? So recent disease, what is the recent disease? Most of the people infected. So little bit updated, it is Ebola. Ebola virus, right? So Ebola virus, fine. So now out of this 1 lakh people, 70,000 people died due to a disease called Ebola. Now my target is to find a medicine for Ebola disease. Okay, so now my target is I need to find a drug which will cure your Ebola virus. Okay, fine. So now your scientists, what they do is they start studying this Ebola virus. So in 1 minute, how many times this virus is multiplying? And they will also find a chemical which is going to effectively work with this Ebola virus. So it should not increase. For the first time, what they do is they'll stop multiplying these viruses. And at the same time, after this achievement is done, slowly they will try to kill the virus which is already present inside your body. This is how your development cycle goes on. Suppose to say our scientist has developed a molecule called XYZ. And research scientist says, my XYZ molecule or tablet will cure Ebola. Okay, he has done some laboratory experiments. He found that, so this XYZ tablet is fighting effectively with Ebola virus. Fine. So now with this statement, can I directly take this XYZ and dose it to a patient who is suffering from Ebola? No, because whenever I use the terminology patient, by default his resistance power is less. And without knowing the, or without understanding the toxicity of this molecule, whenever I say tablet, your tablet is nothing but some combination of some chemicals, some charidon, paracetamol. So these are all your combination of some chemicals. Without understanding the toxicity of chemical, if I directly dose it to humans, what can happen? So the patient may die, chances of getting die. So the person may get some side effects, to the extreme patient may die. Okay, without proper testing, I can't directly dose my tablet on patients or human beings, whatever it is. So for this, your laboratory scientist, your scientist will do some laboratory tests. Okay, so we have two types of studies called in vivo studies, in vitro studies. Vinara, have you heard this name, in vivo, in vitro? Right. So in vitro studies means experiments which we do in a laboratory. We call it as in vitro studies. So in laboratory, they do some experiments. And once this molecule is absolutely fine, what they do? Okay, this molecule is okay for next stage of testing. They say that. Okay, experiments which we do in lab. experiments which we do in lab, we call it as in vitro. And next one is in vivo. Experiments which we do in living beings. Okay, experiments which we do in living beings, humans, animals, whatever it is. Okay, we call it as in vivo studies. So first of all, they do some in vitro studies. After that, this molecule is found to be safe. Then they dose this molecule XYZ on animals. Okay, then they dose this molecule XYZ on animals. Experiments which we do on animals, we call it as preclinical studies. Experiments on animals, we call it as preclinical studies, preclinical trials. Okay, suppose to say we take 20 animals. Okay, we take 20 animals. So now to these 20 animals, I am dosing my tablet XYZ. So after 15 minutes, after 20 minutes, I am going to assess. Okay, so after half an hour, whether this animal is safe or not. I mean to say, the animal is not getting any side effects. Okay, if the animal, 20 animals are not getting side effects, then I can say XYZ is safe on animals, because it is not creating any disturbance or problem to the animal. Suppose to say one animal got died. Out of these 20 animals, one animal got died. So can I say this molecule is safe? No. So out of 20, one animal is died. Out of 200, how many will die? 10. Out of 2000, so goes on. Fine. So now we can't straight away confirm that this molecule is not safe. Now what we do is, we will take this animal case study. So we take this animal as case study. All 19 animals are okay. Why this one animal is not okay? We start another study. So this goes into the domain called pharmacovigilance. This goes into the particular domain called pharmacovigilance. Pharmacovigilance people will study each and every report, each and every parameter of this animal. And finally, they will confirm, boss, this death was not due to your XYZ molecule. This animal internally has some effects. Due to this reason, this animal was dead. So if you are getting this report from your pharmacovigilance team, no issues, you can move to next level. Suppose to say the pharmacovigilance team has concluded that this death has happened due to this drug only. Then in that case, you are not supposed to go forward. Again, you have to go back to your formulations. You have to create a formulation again. Okay. Suppose to say think positive, we are done. So 19 animals survived. 19 animals are okay. And one death happened. But that death is not due to our XYZ molecule. So now you can say your XYZ molecule is safe on animals. Okay. XYZ 500 mg. Tablets 500 mg. Supposed to say. Dose is also important, right? XYZ 500 mg tablets. Fine. Right. So now your preclinical trials are successful. Because there are no issues with animals. All are okay. Next level is, we will conduct this experiment in human beings. Okay. Clinical trials are mainly classified into four phases. When we are doing it on humans, we have four phases of clinical trials. Phases of clinical trials. Okay. It's nothing but phase 1 to phase 4. Okay. Right. So we go step by step. What is a phase 1 trial? Okay. What is a phase 1 trial? So phase 1 trial, what we do is, we will take healthy volunteers. Suppose to say, if you are taking a patient and if you are dosing it, what happens? Patient may die. If it is going extreme, animal, that is fine, it is okay. I can't exactly say that human beings also respond in the same way. I doubt. Okay. So for this reason, what we will do is, in a phase 1 trial, we will collect 100 healthy volunteers. 100 healthy volunteers. Okay, right. So when can I say a person is healthy? When can I say a person is healthy? So if he is free from disease and if he is not having any side effects, right? So now to confirm a person is healthy, anyone has gone through a fitness certificate for any exam in the past? No, fine, no issues. So now first point to check here is height, weight and the related parameter BMI. Okay, so your BMI should be in the area 18 to 23. Strictly saying it is 18 to 23. So if your BMI is in the range 18 to 23, then only you can say this person is healthy, otherwise no. Okay, added to this x-ray, heart related, right? X-ray, ECG. So what is the difference between x-ray and ECG? X-ray will give you the shape. Okay, so simple understanding, because I am not a guy from clinics, so you are far better than me, I understand, but still for a common man to understand, x-ray will give the format, like how the shape of your heart is. Okay, ECG will give you the functionality, how your heart is working. Okay, ECG stands for electrocardiogram, right? So x-ray, ECG and ophthalmology is related to eye, right? Added to this, how many parameters we have? 1 2 3 4 5 6. Added to these six parameters, again we have some laboratory tests such as hematology, serology, biochemistry, urinary analysis. So these are the tests of your laboratories. So now hematology will have 10 parameters. Approximately say we have 10 parameters here. Approximately 10 parameters we have. So your hematology will give you the count for WBC, RBC, blood platelets, etc. Okay, percentage of your hemoglobin, etc. So likewise, each and every laboratory test will give you 10 parameters, will have separate 10 parameters. So now 10 fours are how many? 40 parameters. Okay, this also will have 10 parameters approximately. Right, so this also will have 10 parameters approximately. Fine. So total 40 plus 6, how many parameters? If 46 parameters are okay, then only I confirm this person is healthy. So today's lifestyle, how many people will be okay with all these 46 parameters? If I wanted to get 100 healthy volunteers, how many persons I need to test? 200, 300, 500? See, most of the people are filtered at your BMI itself. As per today's lifestyle, even my BMI is nearer to 23.1. Now even 23.1 my BMI is, I daily check. 23.1 is again out of specification. So as per your height, your weight is more. Correct. So even then it is 0.1, 0.2 also you are out of the trial. You are not a healthy volunteer. So even then all other 40 parameters are also okay. This one parameter is out of the limits, you are out of the trial. Okay, with these specifications, if I want 100 healthy volunteers, what I need to do? I have to test at least 500 healthy volunteers. Agree? 500 healthy volunteers I need to test. Okay, whenever I am testing, I will get data. Okay, whenever I am testing, I will get data. Okay, this data will be stored in different formats such as Notepad, Excel, CSV. So some company uses MS Access, some company uses SQL, Oracle. Okay, so Notepad, Excel, CSV, MS Access, SQL, Oracle. So these are the different types of sources, data sources, where you can store data. Okay, fine. So in Excel you will store. Suppose you are working for CRO 1. Your CRO is storing data in some Excel file. Okay. Now you are working in a CRO. Your CRO is storing data in some SQL. Okay. Now coming into SAS. SAS software is designed in such a way that it will read data from any kind of data source. Okay. Basically, SAS has four functionalities here. Basically, SAS has four functionalities here. If anybody is asking you why you are learning SAS, what is the importance of SAS? You can define your SAS in four ways, in four functionalities. First one is your data access. Second one is your data management. Third one is your data access. Fourth one is your data presentation. And fourth one is your data presentation. So these are the four important functionalities in SAS we have. Okay. Data access. Data interpretation. Interpretation is nothing but interpreting your analysis results. Interpretation, data interpretation or presentation. Third one is your data analysis, sorry. Fourth one is data presentation or interpretation, anything is fine. Right. So I 100% have faith in you. Before completing the sessions, you guys will write a program in SAS. I have that confidence in you. How many you have? You are RAS students now. You should be 100% confident. Okay. I 100% assure you are going to write an exam. You are going to write a program today. SAS software is very easy. Very easy. People with no computer background also will be able to easily do a program in SAS. Okay. So every one of you will write a program before you leave the session, 1 hour session. Okay. Right. So now our point is I have to write a condition for all these 46 parameters. Okay. So now again, these parameters also change with a variable, with respect to a variable called sex. For males, your percentage of hemoglobin is different. For females, again, it is different. All your laboratory parameters with respect to gender changes. Okay. So now I already have this data in Excel. Will it be easy for me to write a conclusion by looking at 46 parameters? Okay. I'll write it. See, this is your real-time scenarios data. This is your subject ID. This is your subject name. This is your subject gender. Age. Okay. And I have my parameter 1. Param 1. Param 2. Okay. Suppose to say I have 8. So this is your total. Okay, 9, 10 also I can write. This is your final conclusion. Okay, this is your final conclusion. Okay or not okay. So, param 8. Param 9. Param 10. Suppose to say I have 10 parameters. So, 10 parameters, I have some values. Suppose to say subject number 1, some name. Subject number one, some name, I have some XYZ, gender is male, age is some 29, suppose parameter 1. So this is the parameter 1. What is the parameter 1? It is WBC. So WBC is some, suppose 150 or 200, suppose. I am giving rough values. So it is 2 or 50. So 320, so 5, something values I am given. Okay. So now I have to confirm whether this value is okay or not okay. Correct. Okay, I have to keep this in mind. I have to keep this in mind. Okay, this is also okay. This is also okay. This is also okay. Okay, 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 okay. So finally, I should write okay. If I'm manually doing this, I have to do this. If I'm skipping one among this, if it is 5 or 6, you can easily make it out. You can write it down. So if it is 46 parameters, in between I got one okay, I forgot it. But still I have written manually, my conclusion there is okay. So this is a big error. Okay. This is a very big error. Right. Right. Okay. Right. So if you are doing manually, things may go wrong. Okay. That is why we need the importance of some sophisticated program. Okay. So if you are writing this program one time, if you are writing this condition for one time, even though if you have one observation, two observations or 10 lakh observations, no issues. Your program will take care. So ipudu chudandi, like if we have 10 observations, jagrataga manage chesi manam cheyochu. 10 observations unnaru anko, 10 subjects unnaru ankonde, jagrataga manam manage cheyochu. Kinda meda padi inkokandi checkpoint pettukoni chesukovochu. Ade na daggara 1 lakh rows unnai, ela chestaru? Manually cheyatam easy na? So then I need the software assistance. Okay, right. So now your client number one is storing this data in Excel file. Now your client number one has come to me, Raj, see, I have some data in Excel. I wanted to get a conclusion based on some specifications. Based on some conditions, I wanted to get this final value. So then he says, boss, I have data in Excel. How you are going to do this analysis in SAS? Okay. In this case, we have two options. Option number one, if your SAS is supporting for copy paste, you can copy all this data, you can paste it in SAS. Option number one. Okay. Suppose to say we will pick option number one. So option number one, I have 1 lakh rows, I'm picking this data. So ilaga control A, control C kotelenga data. Control A, control C kotelenga. Ante like you, we will not do select all and we will not paste it. So at least we'll have a look on data. At least we'll look at some 10 observations or 20 observations. So for the first time, what I have done is I have selected 1000 rows and I pasted it in SAS. This is your SAS, I pasted here. Okay. Again, 10,000 rows I selected and I pasted here. Okay. So now 20,000 observations you got. Okay. Suppose to say this is your 20,000 observations. Now this time, what I have done is I forgot and picked this 20,000th record also. 20,000 record to 30,000 record. This time you will get one record extra because you are supposed to take 20,001th record to 30,000 records. Okay. But you have picked 20,000 record to 30,000 record. So in this case, you will get one extra. Okay. So you have copied all the data, done. Finally, for 1 lakh observations, you are getting 1 lakh 1 observations. So is this easy for me to find this one duplicate record from your raw data? So if you are going with copy paste, you may face such kind of issues. So for copy paste, it will be easy. You will be doing in another 2 hours or 1 hour. That is fine. But to look at this one extra observation, it is very difficult for us. So if you are going with copy paste, you may face such kind of problems. Then second option, what we have? Simply seeing and typing data. Simply seeing and typing the data. That's it. Now here you have 1500. This is 2500 and it is 320. So in place of 320, now we are reading all the data in thousands, right? Forgot you have put 1000 extra, 10 extra. Again, your value is misleading. So copy paste is not allowed. Seeing and typing is also not allowed. Your quality assurance team, in IT also you'll have quality assurance team. Quality assurance team will never accept such kind of softwares. Okay, they always need an automation tool. They always need an automation tool. Your SaaS software is designed in such a way that it will automatically connect to your Excel file, reads data from Excel file into SaaS. While reading, if it is finding any issue, it will clearly tell boss, this is not correct. This variable, this param 3 is not correct. It will clearly tell you. But if you are seeing this data set, your work.ds3 is successfully created. If you are seeing the word successfully created, 100% you check, no issues, you will not find one error also. Okay, right. So this is called automation. So now your client number one has given you data in Excel. No issues. Your SaaS has the provision to read data from Excel. If your client number two has given you data in Notepad, no issues. Okay. So your SaaS software is designed in such a way that it will be able to read data from any kind of data source. So here you can see an example here. Right from Notepad to the sophisticated database Oracle, it is reading all kinds of databases. Okay, right from small file to biggest database, it is connecting to each and every type of data source. Okay, so somehow you have collected your data. Now you were able to pick 100 observations using SAS. Okay, using SAS you are able to pick 100 healthy volunteers. This is one example where you are using SAS in a real-time scenario. One simple example, you can use SAS. Okay, right. Now you got 100 healthy volunteers. Correct. So done. Okay. So 100 healthy volunteers is done. Now suppose if I'm dosing 500 mg, what happens? Because it is an animal, it was able to resist. I can't exactly expect the same with human beings also. Now what I'm going to do is, this 100 healthy volunteers, I'm going to connect, divided it into 5 groups. So each group will have how many observations, how many subjects? 20. Obviously, when I say group 5 groups, you'll get 20 in each group. So group 1, 20 people. So I am very much afraid because my primary objective is please don't hurt others. That too, this person is a healthy volunteer. If anything is happened to this healthy volunteer, people will kill us. The real-time scenarios, particularly when we are doing any trial in Indian market, so if anything is happening, the relatives will come, they'll break down your hospital. Right? They'll charge you like anything. So anyways, it is also strictly not allowed in clinical trials also. What we do is, we take only 50 mg of dose. So real-time scenarios, if any drug, whatever the drug we are taking, it is at least having 500 mg, right? So still I doubt, I should not harm others. So I take very minor dose, 50 mg. So this 50 mg, I'll dose it to 20 people. And I'll keep this 20 people in observation. So whether these people are experiencing any side effects. Side effects in a real-time scenarios, we call it as adverse events. The correct terminology is adverse events. Okay, so whether any of the people is getting adverse events? No, all these 20 people are absolutely fine. That is good. Then I take another group of 20 people. Okay, this time I dose 150 mg to this group. Okay, again I'll put this in observation. So that is fine. If they are okay, then I'll go with group 3. Group 3 is 250 mg. If they are okay, that is fine. If they are not okay, I'll stop this here. I'll say 250 mg is only fine for humans. If they are okay, what I'll say? Group 4. Group 4, I'll go with 500 mg. If they are okay, then group 5, I'll go with 1000 mg. So after taking 1000 mg, people started saying we got gastric pain, we got burning sensation in stomach. Some people say they got headache, they got nausea. Okay. So now here adverse events started. adverse events started. Whenever adverse events started, I say 1000 mg is not safe for human beings. Please go with only for 500 mg dose. Okay, so this is your phase 1 trial. Phase 1 trial is also called as dose proportionality studies. Phase 1 studies are also called as dose proportionality studies because we are proportionately increasing our dose. Okay, right. Phase 1 trials are also called as dose proportionality studies. Once this trial is okay, I confirm 500 mg of XYZ is safe to humans. As per this trial, my safety is approved, right? My primary objective is done. Okay? Right. So likewise, I'll assess my primary objective. Second one is phase 2. So in phase 2, we will find the response of subject towards drug after taking drug. So here we will do this trial on patients. Okay, on patients we do this trial, but we take in a limited number because these are patients. If here and there anything is happening, wickets will go down, right? Fine. So that is the reason we do only limited number of people. We select only limited number of people. Suppose to say some 500 to 2000 people. That's it. So these numbers are only approximation. Again, it depends upon drug variability. These numbers are depending upon drug variability. So the numbers are only approximation, I would say. 500 to 2000 people. If these 2000 people are cured with this XYZ, then they go for phase 3. Otherwise, they have to go back in the beginning. Formulations development, they have to go back. So now, my phase 2 trial is success. If it is success, I'll move to phase 3. If it is failure, what I have to do? Again, I have to start from the beginning. From formulations development, again, I have to do. Okay, right. So suppose to say phase 2 is done. Now, I'll do the trial in phase 3. So you are going to repeat the same trial but with maximum number of subjects. Same trial with maximum number of subjects. Next, phase 4. We have one more phase called, if phase 3 is okay, then you can sell this product in the market. It depends upon the drug variability of the molecule. Okay, sometimes it can be 20,000 subjects, sometimes it can be 15,000, sometimes it can be 5,000. Depends upon the inter-subject variability and intra-subject variabilities. So these are two statistical terms. Depending upon the study design, we have two types of variabilities. If you are doing a parallel design, here comes the concept inter-design, inter-subject variability. If it is a crossover trial, we have intra-subject variability. Going forward, you will learn all these things, no worries. Because I am a master's in statistics, at least the only one advantage you have is, so because I am a guy from statistics, I will explain you 3 to 4 classes in statistics. So that will have a very added advantage. So once you are knowing, understanding the concept, you will understand for which type of data, which concept you have to use. So that gives you a lot of experience as well. So this is one extra advantage you have in when you are going to interviews. Okay, right. And phase 4 trials are called as post-marketing trials. So do you know what is post-marketing trials? Yes. After releasing this product into the market, after 1 or 2 years, again, we will do a research whether this molecule is causing any harm to subject, yes or no. Because we are taking a lot of intake, right? So suppose to say if you are taking 10 tablets, so 10 into 500 mg, 5000 mg. So is it causing any side effects to the subject, yes or no? So likewise, after phase 4 trials, some painkillers were banned. Ibuprofen, Nimesulide. Okay, so there are many trials which are banned after phase 4 trials. most of the painkillers has lot of side effects here. In phase 4 trials, most of the painkillers will come. So that is why always don't take painkillers. Okay, strictly advised. Combiflam is also one drug which is out of phase 4 trial, which is out of market. But daily we are, it is available in Indian market, we are using it. Okay, Nimesulide is available, Combiflam is available, Ibuprofen is available. All these drugs are banned in US because these drugs are having side effects. But Indian government, I don't know when they realize. Banned. Yes, almost like 200 drugs were banned. And in foreign countries also, most of the people, they give only less dose. People who are going and settling there, they give 200 mg, they will not fit to our body also. So this might be, many of people might have experienced this. Their people will give only limited dose. But here without we are taking 500 mg, our dose will not be, our this is like whatever problem we have, it will not be cured. Our bodies are tended to have 500 mg dose. Then only our bodies will respond, otherwise no. So this is all about your clinical trial domain. Okay. Coming to SAS, coming to technology. So any questions from domain perspective? Any questions from domain perspective? So are we using SAS in clinical trial? Are we using SAS in clinical trial? Right? Fine. So coming to domain perspective, I told you there are four important basic functionalities in SAS. First one is data access. So note it down, this is important. Data access. So data access means SAS has the access to connect to any kind of data source. SAS software is designed in such a way that it will be able to connect it to any kind of data source. Access card, if I swipe my access card, what it will do? It will allow me to enter into the office cabin. Right. Likewise, SAS has access to connect it to any kind of data source. SAS has access to enter into Excel, to enter into a notepad file, to enter into a SQL, MS Access, and the list goes on. Okay, so data access, this concept is, it reads raw data from source to SAS application. Okay, here we are going to cover the topics like infile statement, prop import. These are all your SAS topics which we are going to cover in our upcoming sessions. So each and every data source will have different types. Okay, if you wanted to read data from text document, I mean to say notepad file, we use infile statement. If you wanted to read data from Excel, we use proc import. Likewise, depending upon different data sources, we use different concepts to read data in SAS. Next concept is data management. Data management is nothing but rearranging data as per your requirement. Data management is nothing but rearranging data as per your requirement. It is nothing but shapes data into a form required by the application. So Dane, simply I told you, rearranging data as per your requirement. So here the topics we are going to cover are set, merge, format, informat, etc. So these are only few basic concepts, like we will go into much detail. Okay, apart from this also we go much into detail. Okay, right. Fine. So suppose to say I have data here. This is male. This is female. Male, 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 female, male, female, male, female. Okay. So now if you are doing this manually, it will be very difficult for you because the parameters for male will change with respect to females. So now data management is nothing but arranging data as per your requirement. See, if you are writing male, female, chances of getting confused is high. So what I am doing is I will put all female observations to one side and male observations to other side. So now what I can do is I can sort my data. See. So now what I am doing, all males are coming to one end and females are coming to one end. So this concept is called data management. Okay. This concept is nothing but data management. You are rearranging data as per your requirement. So like you can see here, because this is all male, so a condition better run this course. Because this is all female, you can run with one condition. No need of confusion. అదే ఇక్కడ అనుకోండి, ఇక్కడ మేల్ వచ్చింది, ఇక్కడ మళ్ళీ ఫీమేల్, మళ్ళీ ఫీమేల్ గుర్తు తెచ్చుకోవాలి, మేల్ మళ్ళీ అగైన్ ఫీమేల్ గుర్తు పెట్టుకోవాలి. సో జాగ్రత్తగా చేయాలి. అదే మేల్ అంతా ఒక దగ్గర, ఫీమేల్ అంతా ఒక దగ్గర ఉందనుకోండి, మనకి ఇష్యూస్ ఏమీ ఉండవు. రైట్. నౌ యూ హ్యావ్ ఆర్గనైజ్డ్ యువర్ డేటా ఇన్ ఎ సిస్టమాటిక్ మేనర్. దిస్ ఇస్ నథింగ్ బట్ యువర్ డేటా మేనేజ్మెంట్. నౌ డేటా అనాలిసిస్. డేటా అనాలిసిస్ నథింగ్ బట్ total, how many have you tested? So total I tested some 70,000 people. Okay, total I tested 70,000 people. Or suppose I say less amount, 5,000 people. Out of these 5,000 people, how many are males? Males are 3,000. Females are 2,000. Okay, out of this, how many people are greater than or equal to 18 years age? Because without 18 years, this person can't participate in a clinical trial. So out of these 5,000 greater than or equal to 18 years, you have 4,500 people. Okay. Out of this, again, males are how many? Females are how many? So males are 3,000, females are 1,500. Okay. Out of this 5,000 people, how many are okay? How many has passed this parameter? So out of this 4,500, 3,000 people were okay in all parameters. All parameters okay, you got 3,000 people. So out of this 3,000 people, how many are males? How many are females? So here you have 2,000 males and 1,000 females. So likewise, you will do some analysis, right? So all these analysis you will be able to do using your SAS software. This concept is called data analysis. This concept we call it as data analysis. This is a simple example to understand what is a data analysis is. Okay, right. So your data analysis using SAS, you will be able to do small addition subtractions to the maximum. In statistics, we have a concept called simulations theory. This is the most tough and complex concept in statistics. So those kind of complex analysis also you were able to do in SAS. And whatever the result your SAS is generating, it is 100% correct. And it is approved by USFDA. USFDA stands for United States Food and Drug Administration, right? It is approved by USFDA. So whenever your regulator is supporting, without testing they won't support, right? So they have done all these kinds of analysis and they found that SAS is giving the accurate results. Whatever the result your SAS is producing is 100% correct, provided if you are writing a correct syntax and if you are supplying a correct data to it. ఓకే, మనం డేటా కరెక్ట్గా ఇవ్వకుండా హౌ కెన్ వీ ఎక్స్పెక్ట్ కరెక్ట్ రిజల్ట్? వెన్ వీఆర్ నాట్ రైటింగ్ ఎ కరెక్ట్ ప్రోగ్రామ్, యూ కాంట్ ఎక్స్పెక్ట్ ఎ కరెక్ట్ రిజల్ట్. ఓకే, రైట్. సో ఇన్ స్టాటిస్టిక్స్ వీఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు కవర్ ది టాపిక్ సచ్ యాజ్ సమ్. ఇట్స్ నథింగ్ బట్ టోటల్, మీన్స్ నథింగ్ బట్ యావరేజ్. ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ ఇస్ నథింగ్ బట్ కౌంట్, హౌ మెనీ ఆర్ దేర్. యూనివేరియట్ ఇస్ ఆల్సో నథింగ్ బట్ ఎ కాన్సెప్ట్ విచ్ గివ్స్ యూ డిస్క్రిప్టివ్ స్టాటిస్టిక్స్ such as minimum, maximum, average, standard deviation, likewise. So ANOVA is one statistical concept. I think most of you people have heard ANOVA, analysis of variance, correct? Fine. Uttana, what is ANOVA? Just okay. So whenever I talk about statistics to pharmacy guys, oh my god, I don't want statistics, right? Because all problems. So generally this is basic psychology of a pharmacy background. So when coming to statistics, I don't know sir, I didn't understand anything from stats. Correct. Again, it depends upon the person who is teaching you, training you also, because statistics is very such a good concept. I like that, and I'm doing my master's in statistics. Sorry, not master's, PhD. I am done with my master's. Okay, right. So chi-square, CMH, Cox-Mantel-Hessels test, GLM, generalized linear model, regression, correlation, standard deviation. So don't worry, these are all your statistical concepts. I'll take a special class for you. Almost all 4 to 5 classes will be there. I'll spend on statistics to make you understand what is GLM, what is chi-square, what is ANOVA, because this is also much required. Okay. And one more thing here is, I define my course in such a way, I define my notes in such a way that after the completion of my course, my student competency should match with a plus 2 years experienced guy. Okay. So after completion of the course, your competency should match with a plus 2 years of experienced guy. That is the reason I take 45 days. Otherwise 30 days is far enough for completing your technology. If you go outside, you'll find many people, you'll do, sir, this is what, nothing, sir, we'll do it in 20 days, we'll do it in 30 days. But I don't want to go like that. So whatever the training we give, it should be 100% helpful for the person. With this training, the person should be able to work comfortably in a real-time scenarios. Because many people are coming with certain gaps in their studies. If they wanted to go for plus two, fake. So that person should fit in that domain. That person should fit in the role. So that is why from the beginning, day one onwards, my notes will be in such a way that, first of all, I'll explain you how to write a program for a basic level. Once you are habituated to that, again, I'm going to show the same program. This is how an experienced programmer is going to handle this logic. Okay. So I'm going to train you both in zero level, at the same time plus 2 years experiential level. So this will help you a lot in a real-time scenarios. Okay, right. Okay. And I'm happy to say that 44 people has been placed in different companies. Because again, it's all their hard work, and I just only guided them. So it's all their hard work. So 44 people, and till today, they didn't come back to me asking a question, Raj, what is this? Because they have got all that required 2 years skills in this course, and they have practiced after 1.5 months. So already they have practiced 1.5 months, seriously, rigorously they have practiced. And most of the people you can find in Accenture, in Quintiles, Paraxel, even in Cognizant Mumbai. So many big companies they were placed in, right? Fine. Sorry? Who will? Established?
Yeah.
I don't know yet. I'm working for the past 3 years, but before that I don't know. Okay, right. So topics covers in data presentation. Our next concept is data presentation. Now you got this result here, right? This result, it will display in SaaS environment. Agree? So now I should share this result with my client. Again, what I have to do? Copy paste? No. See and writing? No. Okay. Your SaaS software is designed in such a way that it will automatically export results into a PDF document. It will create results into a Word document, into an Excel document, into a HTML document. So basically, whenever you are expecting a client, you will expect this basic software, PDF, Word document, Excel. So now your SaaS software has the provision to export this result into a PDF. If your document is 100% secured and if you don't want to do any edits, so you will send this document in a PDF. So if the client wants to do some edit, he wants to write some more information there, so I'll send this document in Word document. So if your client wants to do some more presentation based on this data, I'll send this document, this data in Excel file. HTML. HTML is basic. Even though if you are not installing your Word document, a PDF, so by default you'll get to your HTML, because with your operating system you'll get this Internet Explorer. You can send this result in HTML views. Okay. So this is the only one software which has all the provisions. Okay. Right. Fine. So now data access, data management, data analysis, data presentation. So any questions from these four topics? Okay, right. So one more point I wanted to tell you here is, I told you SAS will be able to connect a notepad file and to an Oracle. So what is the difference between a file and a database? Simply saying, what I can tell you is, in a file you can store limited number of records. For example, if you are taking an Excel file, you see you will be able to store 10,48,576 records. If suppose if my data is having 11 lakh records, will your Excel file is compatible? No. Is your notepad file compatible? No. Then I have to take the help of my database. So your database is such a software where it will store unlimited amount of data. Unlimited in the sense, it depends upon your CPU size. If your CPU is having 1 terabyte, it will be able to read 1 terabyte data. If your CPU is having 10 terabyte, it will be able to read 10 terabyte of data. List goes on. If you are working on a mainframe, so your mainframe you will have 1000 terabyte. 1000 terabyte means how many GB? 1000 terabyte means how many GB? 1000 into 1024. So this many. 1024,000 GB. It is 1024,000 GB. So this much of amount you can store in Oracle. Okay, right. So 2 GB antenna, like how many songs, how many movies you will get? Or how many video songs you will get? Lot of pics, lot of songs, lot of video songs you will get. Imagine 1,024,000 GB. Okay, it's a huge database. Agree? Right. So whenever your Oracle is able to store 1,024,000 GB, so I said your SAS will also be able to connect a Oracle file. Agree? Your SAS will also be able to connect a Oracle file. If your SAS is reading only 1 lakh GB, is this okay? No. So then your SAS for your competency is not okay. Your SAS software is also more or less equal to a database. If your Oracle is having 10 lakh GB, it will also store 10 lakh GB into your SAS. If your Oracle is having 1 lakh GB, it will store 1 lakh GB. No issues. So more or less, your SAS software is also working like a database. More or less, you are also working as a database tool. Okay, because it also stores unlimited amount of data. And whenever you require one record, in a fraction of a second, it will retrieve that record and it will show. Basically, database has two properties. It will store unlimited amount of data. And second one is, whenever you want particular information, suppose 101 patient information I want. So if you are writing a query, it will display that information in fraction of a second, provided how much big the database is. Fraction of a second, it will retrieve 101 information, patient number 101. So same task your SAS will also do. Okay, same task your SAS will also be able to do. So for 101 record, if you want to bring from SAS, it will also display in fraction of a second. Okay, more or less, your software is also working as a database tool. And point number two, already your software is SAS. In the name itself, it is already mentioned that your software is a analysis tool. Okay, this is an analysis tool. Your SAS software is working as a analysis tool. And finally, data presentation. So you are working this tool as a reporting tool. You are reporting the results to client, right? So the same way your software is also working as a reporting tool. This is the only one software which is working as a database tool, analysis tool, and finally a reporting tool. Okay, this is the only one software which is working as a database tool, analysis tool, and finally a reporting tool. Fine. So do we expect more than this? Do we expect more than this? All your data is given, it is reading. So it is presenting result in whatever the format you want. So not more required, right? So that is why SAS has come into boom. Okay, that is why SAS has come into boom, right? So now, whenever I say my software is working as a database tool, whenever I say my software is working as a database tool, then why should I go for Oracle? Oracle software is also having license. We need to pay 3 lakhs or 4 lakhs for license. Okay, then why should I spend extra amount for license Oracle? Why? No. So whenever you said that so your software is equally working as a database, then why should I go for other data source? Not required. Can I enter data in SAS? So is this possible? Can I enter data in SAS? What do you say? Whenever I say my software is a database tool, I can also enter data in SAS. I can also enter data in SAS. In SAS. No need of depending on Notepad file or Excel file. You can also type your data in SAS and do some analysis. Okay, right. How to write a program in SAS? Okay, how to write a program in SAS? So basically, this is your SAS software. Okay, basically this is your SAS software. Your SAS software has 5 basic windows. This is your editor window. Here you are going to write a program. So this is your log window. It will tell whether you are writing a correct program, yes or no. Okay, here your program will tell whether you are writing a correct program, yes or no. Whether you are writing a correct program, yes or no. Output window. If you are printing anything, that print it will display in output window. So previous example, I have printed some information. So related to adverse event, some demographics. So I printed some information. If your program is generating any printed results, it will display in output window. Right. I'm clearing it now. And additionally, Explorer window. Okay. Explorer window. So whenever I click my Explorer window, you will find like this. Whenever I click my Explorer window, firstly you will find like this. So in Explorer window, you will have set of libraries. Okay, by default in your SAS, you will have 4 basic libraries. By default, whenever you are firstly installing your SAS software, you will have basic 4 libraries. Maps, SAS Help, SAS User, Work. Whatever the file you create in SAS environment, it will sit in your work library. Work library is nothing but a folder. Library is nothing but a folder where you will store some files. Okay. Normally in system we call it folder, right? In SAS we use the terminology library. And results. So your results window will display list of all printed results. How many times you will print all these results, it will display here. Okay, right. So this is just a basic overview. No worries, I will explain in detail in upcoming sessions. Okay, fine. So to write a program in SAS, you have to keep 3 words in your mind. Okay, to write a program in SAS, you have to keep 3 words in your mind. So write a program. So you have to keep 3 words in your mind. In file, input, in file, input, data lines. In file, input, data lines. So these are the 3 words which you have to keep in mind. So for writing a SAS program, you have to keep these three words in your mind. If you are keeping these three words in your mind, you can write a program easy. Okay, right. So always your SAS program will start with a word called data or proc. So anybody has learned C language? No. So in C language, we'll have a void hash main. Adi start in the program rastam. So now to start a program, we will write a keyword called data. If you are not writing data and if you are trying some other text here, see. If you are not writing a program, if you are writing some text here, see. Sample. It is displaying in red, means it is a error. So before running the program itself, you can ensure whether you are writing a program or not. Okay, right. So data. So I have to give my file name, right? So data, it is, I'm giving my name, SAS file name, I'm giving Raj. So what are the three important words I asked to keep in mind? In file. So first one is in file data lines. First one is in file data lines. This is a standard text. In file data lines is a standard text. And one more point to keep in mind is at the end of line, you have to give semicolon. At the end of line, you have to give semicolon. Next important word I ask to keep in mind is input. Input ID, name, age. Okay, so at the end of the line, I have to give my semicolon. So next important word I ask to keep in mind is data lines. Right. So whenever I'm writing data lines, it is an instruction to SAS from next line onwards, I'm typing my raw data. From next line onwards, I'm typing my raw data. So ID number 101, patient name, ABC, age, sum 26. 102, patient name, XYZ, sum 29. So for raw data, not required, semicolon not required. So whenever you are seeing any text in yellow color, there you should not give any semicolons. So finally, you will give this semicolon. This is all one step. And always keep in mind, your program should always end with run statement. Without run, your program is incomplete. Okay. In SAS, we have basically two types of variables. Here we call it as variables. ID number, name, age. So in Excel also, whenever you are trying to give information, what we will do? We'll give ID first, name first, age. Correct. So the same information I'm giving in SAS using input statement. First of all, we'll give your variable names. After that, we will type data here. 101, 102, like this, correct? Okay, first of all, you'll give variable names like this, and after that, you'll give 101, 102 like this. Okay, so first of all, I'm giving input, ID, name, age. Under that, we are giving data, 101, ABC, 26. So make sure, whatever the variable order you are creating, your raw data should also be like this. Otherwise, if you type 26 here, what happens? ID number becomes 26, and your age becomes 101. Is this correct? No. So the data should be as per the same order how your variables are created. Okay. So finally, here, one second. Fine. So finally, here in SAS, we have two types of variables. One is character, other one is numeric. character numeric. So numeric variables means this variable, id variable is there na? Id variable will read 101, 102, it will read numbers. Comma dates. Character means it will read alphabets and special characteristics. Star, hash, ampersand, percentage, like this. So using your keyboard you can give only numbers, alphabets, like this. Correct. So now whenever you are creating a variable, by default it will understand it is a numeric data type, means it will assume numbers. So by default whenever you are creating a variable, it will expect numbers into this variable. But here if you observe name, name is not having numbers. So it should read some characters, I mean to say some alphabets. So whenever you wanted to read alphabets into this variable, you have to give a dollar symbol. You have to give a dollar symbol. Okay. Whenever you wanted to read alphabets into your variable, you have to give a dollar symbol after that variable name. So this gives the difference between a character and numeric. Okay. Right. So now if I write one more variable sex, and your sex is having the values male, female. For your variable sex, do I need to write dollar symbol, yes or no? For your variable sex has to read small m, small f. If you wanted to read alphabets into your variable, then I have to give a dollar symbol. If it is numbers, not required. If suppose if it is height, height is 172 centimeters, 169 centimeters. If it is numbers, no need to give anything. If it is alphabets, you have to give dollar symbol. If it is numbers, no need of giving anything. If it is alphabets, you have to give dollar symbol. Okay. Simply run your program. Okay. Simply run your program. So to submit a program, you have to click this icon, see. To submit a program, you have to click on this icon. Submit. Small kid running symbol here, right? Border paragatunatunda. That is run. So I submitted my program. Once I submitted my program, I have to check whether I'm writing a correct program, yes or no. So then immediately you have to go and see your log window. So are you finding any text in red color here? Are you finding any text in red color here? So 100% you can confidently say my program is correct, because you are not finding anything in red color. Okay. And it is saying the data set work.raj has two observations. Two observations means two rows. How many columns I have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 columns. Columns are called as variables. You can see this is 5 variables. Okay. 5 variables. Now, if you wanted to see this, Raj, you have to go to work library. And you are already in work library here. Correct. So if you wanted to go, first of all, your libraries will be like this. In your Explorer window, first of all, it will display like this. You need to click on libraries. And in libraries, you will find four icons. Work. In work, you can see your Raj. So this is what the information you have given in your SAS. You can see here, see. 101, 102. Name, ABC, XYZ. Age, 26, 29. Sex, male, female. 172, 169. So this is the raw data which you have given in SAS. You can see here, correct? Both are same, 100% accurate. Agree? Right. So this is how we write a program in SAS. So this program confirms without a database also you can enter data in SAS. Okay. First thing is your data, your program should start with data, and it should end with run statement. This is point number one you have to keep in mind. Point number two is, it is everywhere it is ending with semicolon, except data lines, except this yellow color. Okay, and finally run. That's it. If you wanted to read alphabets, you will give dollar symbol. If you wanted to read numbers, nothing, no need to give anything. And you have to keep three words in your mind: in file, input, data lines. Okay, right. So now, who is ready to write a program? Superb. So sir, am I starting rally in another? Right. Okay. So one second, just hold on the line. So one of our friend is going to write a program here. Okay, right.